They're closer now. Stabs of pain in my back.
Back pain, Chuck. Here's a hint. Back labor. The other way, please, Carol.
He just kicked.
You okay, Carol?
Yeah.
Good. Now, how far apart were those contractions? Chuck is doing a great job of simulating new father's labor room panic syndrome. It helps if you start the watch. Okay, who'd like to be next?
We will.
Don't worry, we're going to be great parents.
Right here.
Okay.
Oh, I'll get the pill.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, you want her to breathe?
Are you all right?
How do you think of all those questions?
Because I want to do this right. Good night, guys.
Good night, Carol. See you later.
You look like you were about a million miles away in there.
I was thinking about you.
That's so sweet.
You know, the irony is you'll probably never even get a chance to use what we learn in this class.
Why not?
Chuck, your head is still not in this, is it? Dr. Miller says I have placenta previa. There's a 90% chance I'm going to have a C-section.
Oh, whatever happens, I'll be there with you.
It's 510 State Police, Boston.
My wife's been shot. I've been shot.
Where is this, sir?
I have no idea. I was just coming from Tremont, Brigham and Women's Hospital.
We have two shooting victims, Boston. And where are you now, sir?
I don't know. I don't know. He drove us. He made us go to an abandoned area.
Is he still in the area?
No, he took off.
No location yet, Boston. We're working on it.
We have 5 units in the area. Just ask the guy where he is.
Get an address.
Look around you, sir.
Oh, man.
Tell us where you are.
Oh, man. I'll start the car. He took the keys, but I have a spare set.
Just stay on the phone with me, buddy. I'm going to get someone to you.
All units, we've got a shooting. Tremont Street, near the hospital. All units, we have a shooting. Tremont Street, near the hospital.
Now, your wife has been shot as well?
Yeah. In the head. I ducked down.
Can you look out?
Can you get out of the vehicle and look around you to see where you are? I'm trying to get someone to you.
Should I drive up to the corner?
If you can drive without hurting yourself, yes, sir. And what's your name, sir?
Stewart. Chuck Stewart.
Boston wants a description of his vehicle.
What color's your car, buddy?
Blue. It's a blue Toyota Crescent.
Blue Toyota Crescent.
Is your wife breathing?
She's still gurgling. Oh, man. I'm turning onto a busy street. I recognize where I am now. Should I drive to the hospital?
Just tell me what the street is, Chuck.
It's Tremont Street.
Tremont and what else? Chuck?
Tremont and what else?
Cash sign.
Pull over to the side of the street, and I want you to talk to any passerby so as I can get an indication as to where you are, Chuck.
I'm looking. I'm looking. There aren't that many people. Oh, man. I'm blacking out.
You can't black out on me, buddy. I need you, man. Chuck? Chuck?
I hear a siren, boss.
That's one of my guys. I've got him flooding the area. Wait a minute.
Bravo 101, sound your siren.
Everybody else, kill yours.
You get a siren yet?
Negative on Bravo 101, Boston.
Chuck?
Bravo 201, sound your siren.
Chuck?
Still nothing, Boston.
Bravo 201, kill your siren. Bravo 104?
Sound your siren.
Chuck? Chuck? Come on, Chucky, I can hear you breathing. Come on, Chuck. Pick up the phone, Chuck. Chuck, we're losing him. Come on, Chuck. Talk to me, buddy. Come on, Chuck, pick up the phone. Chuck Stewart. There's a siren.
That's it, Boston, you're right on top of him.
Let me take a man.
I got it.
Stand back,
man.
Yeah.
Be careful with her.
Watch your wrist.
Nobody told
her
she was pregnant.
Back over there.
Yeah.
Bravo 38.
Shots.
We got more.
Kill me.
Backboard.
Backboard here.
Get oxygen. Call Brigham Hospital. Tell them we got a pregnant woman. She's been shot in the head. She's in full arrest.
Yeah, it was a black guy.
Took
all my wife's jewelry.
You got an IV line?
Wait, look, you know what he was wearing?
He's wearing one of those black running suits. With three red stripes.
IV's there.
All right, where'd this happen, sir?
He was stopped for a light on Tremont Street. He jumped in the back seat and he told us to drive. He shot my wife.
Sir, I'm gonna put some oxygen on you. Take a deep breath.
Medic, let's go, please. All right, okay, let's go.
Bravo 102, yeah, we're here at the hospital.
Okay, buddy, we're gonna have you inside the barrier. Over here on the side.
Right there.
All right, we're rolling.
Go ahead. Take him to three.
Where's my wife?
She went to a different hospital.
Mr.
Stewart? I'm Detective McQuiggan. I'm with Boston Homicide.
Can you tell us anything more about this guy?
Black. Detective, you can't be in here now.
Just 30 seconds more, please. He's black. He's about your height. Got a black running suit, is that right?
One. Yeah,
get him over.
Two.
Three.
Okay. All right. Take the mask off you here.
Yeah.
Charles, how are you feeling?
All right.
How's the breathing?
Can you give us anything more on this guy?
He has a pulse.
Black, he's about your height, and he's wearing a black running suit. Anything else?
Take a deep breath.
His voice was kind of raspy.
Nurse, let's get a blood pressure.
Now, we jumped into the car with you, right? About how old was he?
Patient has good breath sounds.
Late 20s, early 30s.
And he had a gun?
Can we order some x-rays?
It was one of those short 38s.
Okay.
Silver plate.
Blood pressure.
Do you remember how many shots?
Three shots.
Oh, God.
It's my wife. Then I ducked down, and it hit the roof, and the third one hit me.
Can
we roll up?
Okay.
Can we get some blood ready?
Any more wounds?
Just the one in the flank. Chuck, help me out here, please. Are you sure there were only three shots?
Yeah, three shots. I heard the gun jam.
Mr. Stewart, you want me to call someone for you?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Detective, you've got to leave now.
Charles, I need you to wiggle your toes.
He saw our car phone.
You wanted to steal it?
No. He figured we were undercover
cops.
Can
you get another blood pressure?
You're 5-0, he said.
Thanks, Chuck.
You feel your toes?
Notify surgery.
What do you got? Plenty. I'll call it in. Now you start calling the guys at home. The black son of a bitch is a cop killer.
You can still see the bloodstains on the pavement here, where just a few hours ago, a Redding couple was gunned down in their car by an unknown assailant, described by police as a black man in his late 20s to early 30s.
Hey, Caruso, come look at this.
One, he's underestimating Boston PD. Two, he's insulting the intelligence of the feds on the strike force. And three, the next time he calls me a girl...
Boston Herald, Metro.
I'm gonna take out my rubber gloves and turn the bilious slime ball into a boy soprano. What?
Black guy in Mission Hill just blew away a couple of yuppies for a few bucks worth of jewelry.
You shot both of them?
Couple from Redding. White.
What were they doing down there? Making a buy?
Coming home from birthing class at the Brigham.
Oh, that's a first for Boston. If it's true.
And any word on Mrs. Stewart?
Sir.
Mr. Mayor?
Mrs. Stewart was pronounced dead a few minutes ago.
Can you give us any information on the crime?
This crime tells us something we already know. There are too many guns, too many drugs on the streets of Boston. For a man to kill a pregnant woman to leave the baby in a coma. The citizens of Boston are outraged, and rightly outraged, at this kind of violence on our streets.
What can you tell us about the investigation?
I've asked the commissioner to put every single available detective in the city of Boston on this case to find the person responsible for this cowardly, senseless tragedy.
South Boston, you're on the air live.
Okay, listen, Steve. All these callers who have been saying Charles Stewart was a hero, well, I think he was pretty stupid. You take your life into your hands going into an area like Mission Hill.
Now, hold on a minute.
Guns, drugs, murder, prostitution.
Let's not condemn a whole neighborhood.
Well, it's not just one neighborhood. Roxbury, Dorchester, Mattapan. It's not safe to go into any of those areas without a gun, and it's not safe to go into them at all after dark.
Don't you think that's a little extreme?
No, I don't. Charles Stewart, he grew up around here. He should have known that.
Thanks for your call. Marblehead, you're on the air.
Yes, I'm a first-time caller, Steve, and you know, your attitude really ticks me off.
My attitude?
Yes. When are you going to stop pussyfooting around the issues, my friend? A pregnant woman gets shot in the back of the head, that's an execution. When they catch this black guy, that's what I need to do to him. Execute him. And that's why we need to bring back the death penalty.
Hey, buddy.
What's your name?
How do you do about
it?
I don't know.
Where you live, buddy?
I don't know.
You seen anybody? You seen anybody with a gun around?
You know about Mrs. Stewart? You don't know?
What's happening? What's your name?
Nobody knows.
Come on. Is your son here? Is this your son? Okay, buddy. You seen anybody?
You don't know nothing. Like
look. How long have you been here? How long have you been here? How long have you been here? 2 days?
2 days.
Are you from around here, buddy?
You'll have to wait till your parents come out, Michael. Only two visitors at a time. You're all family?
Yeah, except Janet, Matthew's girlfriend. She's practically family.
I'm sorry. She'll have to wait outside. How's the pain today? Can I have a minute alone with him?
Doctor, if he needs specialists or extra treatments, we have savings. He's our oldest.
Mrs. Stewart, trust me. He's getting the best. Everything he needs. This is Demerol. Give me sleep here a few minutes. I just spoke with the neonatal unit. Your son's holding us out. I'll tell your family.
Doctor? Did my wife ever regain consciousness?
Charles Stewart, who heroically summoned aid for his dying wife, was a well-to-do suburban fur salesman who made the mistake of driving home from a birthing class through the wrong neighborhood after dark. And now Charles, with a bullet still lodged in his stomach, fights for life with his premature and perhaps brain-damaged little son, Christopher. Sadly, Charles Stewart was unable to even attend his wife's funeral today, but all Boston grieves with him for his brutally murdered wife, Carol. In Medford, this is Charmaine Jordan, News for New England.
Carol could have no better eulogy today than the words of her loving husband, Charles, read for him by the best man at their wedding, Brian Parsons.
The following is a message from Chuck to his wife, Carol. Good night, sweet wife, my love. God has called you to his hands, not to take you away from me or the happiness and gladness you brought me, but to bring you away from the cruelty and violence that fills this world. He said that for us to truly believe, we must know that his will is done and that there was some right in this meanest of acts. In our souls, we must forgive this sinner because he would too. Now you sleep away from me. I will never again know the feeling of your hand in mine. But I will always feel you. I miss you, and I love you. Your husband, Chuck.
Thank you.
We are gathered together tonight to grieve for Carol Stewart and her baby boy, about whom we've heard so much in our newspapers and on our television, and for James Moody, a black man gunned down on that same night, about whom we've read and seen next to nothing.
That's right.
To the families of Carol Stewart and James Moody, we say to you, as we share your grief, we share your rage. We share your horror that innocent people can no longer pass down the streets of Boston. How can you know what we feel? They cry. And we answer, when the police come into our community, stopping our young people searching for a killer, we say, believe us, we know fear. Now we see the coffins of Carol Stewart and James Moody. And we say, your fear is our fear. But let us not fear each other. We raise our lights to say, let us come out of the darkness of racial hatred together. Let us stand watch together until a new day dawns in Boston. And at that dawn, let the decades of hatred be blown away in a single breath of forgiveness.
Amen.
Description of his vehicle.
What color's your car, buddy?
It's blue. It's a blue Toyota Cressida.
Blue Toyota Cressida.
Is your wife breathing? She's still gurgling. Ah, oh, man. I'm turning onto a busy street. Oh, I recognize where I am now. Should I drive to the hospital?
Just tell me what the street is, Chuck.
It's Tremont Street.
What, are you going back over that thing?
I'm making a transcript.
We already printed a transcript.
We printed excerpts. Stuart was on the phone for 14 minutes and wondered it all.
Why?
Something's wrong. Has your wife been shot? Yeah, in the head. I ducked down. His wife's bleeding on the seat beside him, and he's telling the cops why he's not dead.
Come on. Are you saying you suspect this guy? You've got one big problem. He almost died. He didn't shoot himself in the stomach.
No. He ducked down. He can see bullets coming.
Hey, you've seen the play, the national play that the networks are giving this thing? People think Stewart's a hero for staying on the phone that long with a bullet in his gut.
Well, we care what people think.
We care about being right.
I got something for you on the Stewart shooting. My cousin's nephew. He told her he talked to the guy who did it. Dwayne, this is Pat.
This is Al.
They're straight. Now you tell them what you told Aunt Maddie.
Man, look, that was jive, man.
Some of those details you told her about that wasn't jive, Dwayne.
Larry, just butt out, okay?
Let's pull the jacket on this kid.
Look, I don't got no jacket, all right? Because I ain't never been in no police station before.
He's trying to cover it up.
Say what?
What were you doing hanging out with the killer, Dwayne?
Okay. 8:30. This is where he says the black guy gets in the car.
Look at the cars. Look at the pedestrian traffic. With all these people around, wouldn't somebody have remembered seeing it?
Yeah. A black guy getting into the back of a Toyota. It's a wonder the switchboard wasn't swamped with calls.
Give me a break. Let's drive, okay?
found Stuart's carcass in those weeds.
I can't see any windows. This has to be where it happened. He dials the state police.
It's 510 State Police, Boston.
Start driving.
My wife's been shot. I've been shot. Where is this, sir? I have no idea. I was just coming from Draymond. Bring them all up.
We have two shooting victims, Boston. Now, where are you now, sir?
I don't know. I don't know. He drove us. He made us go to an abandoned area.
Okay, I'm in shock. I don't know where I am.
But you know you have to get to a main street where you can find help.
I'm turning onto a busy street. I recognize where I am now. Should I drive to the hospital? Just tell me what the street is, Chuck. It's Tremont Street. Tremont and what else? Chuck?
Okay, this works. This is the route
Tremont
you must take.
And what else? Cash sign.
Now he sees the sign. Okay, you're wounded. You found your way back to Tremont. What do you do?
I drive the two blocks back to the hospital, or I flag down a pedestrian.
I'm looking. There aren't that many people.
I know. Maybe there was a tornado watch that night. So what does Chucky do?
I'm blacking out. You can't black out on me, buddy. I need you.
And he's gone.
Chuck, I hear a siren busting. Come on, Chucky. I can hear you breathing. Come on, Chuck. Pick up the phone, Chuck. Chuck, we're losing him. Come on, Chuck. Talk
this
to me, buddy.
This goes on for 6 minutes.
Come on, Chuck. I need you, buddy.
You blacked out.
Chuck.
Where's the phone, then? And to fall on the floor?
Come on, Chuck, pick up the phone.
How come we can still hear him breathing?
Chuck Stewart.
Here it is. How could he have blacked out? He had to still be driving because right here is where they found his car.
He found his way back to the main drag and then he turns off it. Why would he do that?
Maybe he was waiting for his wife to die.
The tape does not prove that.
No. But I bet it proves homicide's taken a serious look at Chuck Stewart.
What do you deal, Dwayne? Dime bags?
Look, man, I'm clean, all right? I told you that.
Hold a minute. Yeah, sure. You're just standing around out there passing out Jesse Jackson buttons,
Who is it, Dwayne? Who are you afraid of?
What's the normal sentence these days on obstruction of justice?
What do you mean, for withholding information? It depends.
You say it was a murder case.
That's about 20 years.
Okay. Look, man. Look. I'm gonna tell you what I heard, okay? And then you let me go, okay?
Not unless you did, Mrs.
Man, you crazy?
Sure, go ahead.
Yeah. Willie Bennett did it.
Check it against the prince.
How do you know that, Dwayne?
Bunch of guys was hanging out. Somebody said that they heard Willie did it. Then Willie came back to the apartment bragging about it.
About shooting Carol Stewart?
Yes, yeah. Said it was easy. Laughed about it.
There's the bullet.
Are you just going to leave it there?
The damage has already been done.
But how am I going to be able to live? I mean, am I going to be able to...
You've had major intestinal trauma. You'll heal? You'll go back to work?
But am I going to be impotent?
You've been injured. It was a serious operation. In a few months, the human body has a way of surprising us.
Can we have a few minutes with him, Doc?
Okay. Keep it short.
Right. Thank you.
So how are you feeling, Mr. Stewart?
I keep waiting for the pain to go away. It doesn't.
See? You're up to looking at some photographs.
But you have him, the black guy?
We're getting close. Take your time.
Well, I could have been.
You're not sure, sir?
Well, the first thing he said was, don't look in the rearview mirror.
It would have been one of these guys.
Yeah, it could have been. You know, I didn't get a very good look. Could have been.
Mission 3, that's 110 Liberty, 110 Liberty,
109. Come.
Why not?
You went to college. You're gonna be a lawyer. You can't tell people you go out with a cook.
Oh, there's something wrong with being a cook.
No, I don't think it's exactly what your father has in mind.
Good thing you're not dating him.
I like that. With the sunshine of her smile. And now our Father, may her spirit add to the luster of heaven. Amen. Hi, Jack. Jack, this is Carol's mom and her brother, Carl.
My condolences.
This is my lawyer, Jack Dawley. Jack's going to be handling the probate arrangements, and he'll be running interference with the press.
You two have business.
Won't you come for dinner when you can?
Yeah, I will, Ma.
Okay, thank you.
Listen, I know how you feel, Ma. But she's looking down on us from heaven right now.
It's nice meeting you.
Good people.
I brought you the papers.
Oh, that's all right. The gift shop sends them out.
Not anymore. I told the DA's office I'm screening what you read.
Oh. You talked to Flanagan's office? You told him how eager I am to help.
Your ID's going to be critical.
Did they give you
Any idea about how many suspects they have?
No. But we're not taking any chances. When they do find this guy, the last thing we want is for the defense to be able to have a lineup thrown out.
They could do that?
Well, they could if they could prove that you saw the killer's picture in the paper.
You know, Jack, about IDing the guy, you know, it was kind of dark.
Well, you got to say that. Then see if you recognize anybody. I mean, that's all you can do. All right, I got to get to court.
Hey, look at that. Oh, it's still on the front page after 2 weeks.
Hey, trust me. This case has re-election written all over it. They're going to get this guy.
Yeah, I'll be over here, right?
Mr. Flanagan, how about
Mr. Flanagan, what do you have for us on the Stewart case?
You all know Assistant District Attorney O'Meara. He's coordinating this investigation.
Come on, Flanagan, give us a headline.
O'Meara, we're making progress. No further comment at this time.
When are you releasing the autopsy report?
Ballistics even anything, Flanagan.
Most of the mayor's State of the City speech was about the way he handled the Stewart case. Is he putting heat on you?
The mayor does not run the district attorney's office. We're making progress. That's all I've got for you today.
No, come on.
Come on. You're holding on.
What are you doing here?
I have been dropping dimes on you all week.
Your pit bulls
act like I got bad breath.
Nice talk. You'll never win Miss Massachusetts, Caruso.
Listen, friend, I was working on the route Stewart took when he says he was lost. He made some very funny turns.
Funny?
I'll drive you through it. He says he can't see any pedestrians. I was there on two different nights. The streets are full of pedestrians. Plus, you got a couple in the car. Which one's the bigger threat?
The husband.
So why does this guy shoot the wife and leave Stewart alive?
He ducked.
In a Toyota. With the seatbelt on. You guys are checking this stuff out, right?
We're checking everything out.
Insurance, property records, stuff like that.
You wouldn't be trying to get me to comment on an ongoing investigation.
Huh. Fran, this is me. Just confirm it for me. You're investigating Stewart, right?
No comment. Come on. I got a tough afternoon. Come on. Come on. Hey, Caruso. I'm interested. Call me.
Thank you.
Chuck?
Wait. All right, just a second. Okay. Hi.
Hi. You didn't tell me how bad it was.
Oh, I didn't want to talk about it on the phone.
You'll be okay. Oh, where are my manners? Chuck, this is my girlfriend, Beth.
Hi, Beth.
Hi, Mr. Stewart. I've heard so much about you. Everybody
at
Kegasus.
Every time I tried to call. Whenever I called your house, your mother didn't seem very friendly.
She's afraid of how we'll look.
How what will look?
My talking to you after what happened.
Oh. Well, what's wrong with friends from work getting together and talking?
Well, you know about mothers. No matter how innocent something is, they always think people are thinking the worst. I'm going to find the ladies' room.
It's right down the
hall. No, Beth, you don't go, because I have to go in a minute. I told my mom I'd be home soon.
Oh, come on, you haven't even been here 5 minutes. Oh, it's nice to see somebody. I get lonely lying here.
I can't come back.
I need to talk to you. Here, use my credit card number. That way there won't be any record of the calls.
Well, we gotta go.
Wait. Call me tonight.
After valiantly clinging to life for 17 days, little Christopher Stewart died today in the same hospital where he and his mother, Carol, were rushed minutes after she was shot to death last October 23rd. The death of the premature infant was the 11th fatality in a chain of more than 100 shootings in Boston's inner city in the past 60 days. District Attorney Newman Flanagan's office confirmed today that when the killer is apprehended, he'll be charged with 2 counts of homicide. Bill Larson, WDBX News, Boston.
Thanks, Bill.
What are you doing out here?
Nothing.
You don't talk to me anymore.
I talk.
Not about anything. Is it Christopher?
They're not gonna find any black man.
We don't want to have to keep pulling you in here like this, Duane, so let's get this straight, all right? You heard Willie Bennett admit he shot them. You heard his raspy voice. You saw the gun. You heard him say he told Stewart not to look in the rearview mirror. You heard him say he got into a blue Toyota near Brigham and Women's Hospital.
Look, man, all I heard Willie say was that he shot some folks. I hear all that other crap, all right? I want to think about this.
Bringing up a friend of Willie Bennett's.
Who?
Joni Jackson.
Well, what if she goes back and she tells Willie that she saw Duane in here talking to us?
Well, we can't have that, Al. Duane's our star witness. Let's go, buddy.
Is she gonna talk?
Steno's on the way. Your kid heard him bragging about it. You ready to sign?
Buzz us when you're ready.
Don't forget, Duane's original story didn't include Bennett saying anything about a rearview mirror.
We just want to get into Bennett's apartment.
And if we get the goods, we want it to stick. Just don't make it too good.
It's okay, Duane, you're cool. Now, let's go over what you heard, okay? One more time.
You guys hear the rumors about an arrest in the Stewart case?
Oh.
People in the project say the cops are asking a lot of questions about Willie Bennett.
I'll call you back.
You know about a guy named Willie Bennett?
Yeah, he just got out of Walpole. They got him for sticking up a cop.
With a shotgun.
He shot another cop a few years back, maybe 80, 81. What he's famous for is shooting a double amputee cab driver for a grand total of something like $40.
Bennett's black, right?
Yep. And he fits Chuck Stewart's description.
Oh, like half the black population of Boston.
Wait, I bring you a hot tip, and what do I get? Skepticism.
The guy at the top of every cop's list, plus the biggest murder of the decade. I think that's like maybe a little too convenient, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
People in the projects are talking about how dumb the cops are.
How come?
Only say if it'd been Willie, he'd have taken the car for him.
Hey, Franny. Anything new on the Stewart investigation?
What is it with you and Stewart?
Well, he hired Jack Dawley, for one thing.
Guy can't hire a lawyer?
A criminal lawyer. He used to work for you guys. Now he's with one of the most expensive firms in town. It doesn't look to you like maybe Stewart might have something to hide?
Maybe he just needs somebody to keep vermin like you away.
Very funny. How about letting me take a look at the ballistics report on that car?
You think we leak evidence around here?
In most cases, your office reminds me of a sieve. It's what draws the vermin.
Stewart's surgeon?
Yeah.
He's a Vietnam vet. He saw all kinds of self-inflicted wounds. He told us there's no way Stewart shot himself.
So you are investigating Stewart?
Actually, our investigation's going another way.
Oh, not Willie Bennett. Come on!
I won't comment on specific names.
You are going after the wrong guy, Fran!
Hold it, Willie. Don't move. We'll do it downtown. Come on, let's go.
Mom's expecting us. I just want to make sure everything's okay. Come on in.
I'll wait out here.
This isn't pot roast, it's London broil.
Honey, I manage the store. People expect me to go out for lunch.
Well, I take my lunch. Be honest. You like to go out, you put yourself first. And there's nothing wrong with it. It's just the way you are.
Look, if you want to tell the paper hanger to go ahead with the baby's room, just tell him.
No, just admit what you're doing, that's all. You say yourself you've gone as far as you can in Caicos, so just admit.
You know, there's still plenty of reasons to get out and meet people. There's a future, it's just not at Caicos.
I don't know who's worse, if it's you or me, but the bottom line is we have got to start saving some money.
Saw Carol the other day. She's getting pretty big.
If she's pregnant, that's what happens.
Life's gonna change, my friend. No more basketball, no more Friday nights.
Ah, it's gonna work out good. I'll be at the restaurant, she'll be at home with the kid.
Yeah, sure. The restaurant.
What does that mean?
Chucky, we're never gonna have enough money to open up our own place. Not now. You think there's gonna be only one kid?
Saunders?
He's an insurance agent. A guy at work told me about him. He takes your policies and consolidates them, and the benefits stay the same, but the...
Who told you to take charge of our insurance?
Nobody. I thought it would save us some money.
Well, you don't buy a cheap fur coat, and you don't buy cheap insurance.
I wasn't going to do anything without talking
to you. You're not going to do anything, period.
Some of it's my money, you know. It's money that I've earned.
Well, we're not making any changes in our insurance right now.
Got a buyer for a Russian sable.
I'm not a deli. I don't take orders.
Yeah, why should you? You're making it on both ends, huh? Or maybe I should get a piece of your insurance action.
You just got a divorce, right?
Yeah. Bitch took the house, the kids, the golden retriever, and my Harley.
Well, she probably wanted to sell the bike.
Oh, she sold the dog. She gave the bike to her boyfriend.
At least you're free.
A town like Revere? Come on. Now, you call me about the sable, all right? This is easy money, babe.
Thank you.
tonight?
It's Friday.
You don't eat dinner on Fridays?
You run the lid pressure over that for me?
How about clam chowder? Jack, I'm 7 months pregnant. I don't like to eat dinner by myself.
Are you gonna brush my jacket for me or not?
Are you gonna grow up or not? You're about to become a father, Chuck.
Pick up my jacket. Now.
Don't you understand? What if something goes wrong? What if my water breaks? Who's gonna take me to the hospital?
Don't you ever tell me what I can or cannot do.
When do you want me to tell you it's all right to go out every Friday night? That's great. It's great. Your freedom's very important to me. But tonight, I'm just asking you, please, to stay home with me.
Oh, look at you. You're so fat, you can't even stand up.
Don't go. Please, don't go.
No. My mother used to say pregnancy made a woman more attractive. If she'd never seen you.
Okay, thanks a lot, man. Okay, see you later, Rich. Bye-bye.
They had another photo array.
Who told you?
A cop I know. Stewart was supposed to have turned his face away and sobbed when they showed him Bennett's picture.
He go all the way, he say Bennett pulled the trigger. I don't get it.
Yeah. If Stewart shot her himself, why doesn't he just come right out and pin Bennett?
Michelle? The cops are up to something.
Collecting for Willie Bennett's Christmas turkey.
I want you to go into the projects and find the people who ratted Willie out.
I wrote up Bennett's arrest for you. That was hard enough to stomach. I want to stay on Chuck Stewart.
Covering the police is our job. Bennett is still their leading suspect.
Well, why the hell haven't they charged him then, huh? That's a story. Why don't we print that all over page one, the way we print everything we turn up that says Bennett's guilty?
Are you saying you won't do the story?
It's the wrong story. Chuck Stewart is the story.
Do you have one official source who will even confirm that Stewart is under investigation?
No.
No. Then I want you on this.
It's wrong. The cops are wrong. Our coverage is wrong.
You're the reporter. Prove it to me.
Hey, for me to say. What your cousin say?
Oh, man.
Jump
street.
Oh, no, man. I'm gonna try to get some tickets
to
that game.
Yeah. Tony, it's Michelle Caruso. I called you on the phone.
I got nothing to say to no papers.
Oh, I gotta talk to you. You really want to do this through the door?
Look. You start talking about this out in the hall. You're gonna get me killed.
Here we go, big boy. Look at that, huh?
Look at that stuff.
You sure you want to let him do that?
Works every time.
Hey. How'd you get mixed up in this?
It was three, maybe four nights after the shooting. I was talking with my boyfriend down in the courtyard.
Willie came over. He was drinking. My boyfriend left.
Willie asked if he could tell me something. Then he banged on the wall with his fist and said the bullet wasn't meant for the woman, it was meant for the man.
You say why the bullet was meant for the man?
Because the man owed him money.
For what? For drugs?
I don't know.
Did he actually say the name Stewart?
No. But I knew who he was talking about. The Stewarts was the only couple that was shot down here that week.
And sometimes, the cops in this town, well, you sure they didn't pressure you?
I told them the truth. Just like I told you. The bullet was meant for the man. I heard him say it.
Was Tony ever involved with Bennett?
She says they were friends. There was never anything romantic.
Would she have any other reason for fingering him?
Not that I could see.
But the cops have her testimony, right?
Our sources say that besides Tony, we've got four other witnesses who heard Willie talking about the murders.
Hmm. Kinda blows your theory on Stewart, huh?
What? Not necessarily. Tony never said she heard Willie say he did the shooting, just that he knew about him.
But she hasn't changed her story. I mean, she told you, she told the cops, she told the grand jury, right?
Sat on Tony Jackson's floor and tried to poke holes in her story and ended up believing her.
We're going with this.
A lot of things are going to be clear.
Ready, Mr. Stewart?
Bring him in. Take one step forward when I call your number, then one step back. Number one. And back. Number two. And back. Number three. Mike, could you use a little extra money?
Who couldn't use some extra money?
Well, I got a project you might be interested in.
Well, I gotta sell something?
No, money's coming from insurance.
You're not screwing around on Caicos, are you?
No, what I'm talking about is more like an accident.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about, and I don't want to know.
And back. Four.
Chuck, we kind of lost track since your wedding.
Yeah, we got to go to a ball game or something.
Sounds good.
Because I got this problem I want to talk over with you.
Well, sure, what's up?
Truck drivers know all kinds of people. Union guys, guys in bars.
I'm not following you, man.
I need to have somebody killed.
It's a joke, right?
No, I'm looking for somebody to kill my wife.
I don't know any. Jeez, I don't believe I'm even saying this. How would I know any hitmen?
Well, it doesn't have to be a professional. It shouldn't be. I've got a plan. I just need somebody to do it.
You already planned how to do it?
But Dave, this woman's on my case all the time. I told her I didn't want a baby. She got pregnant anyway. I told her to have an abortion, and she laughed at me. And she's getting the upper hand in our relationship.
Other guys face this kind of situation all the time. Get a divorce.
Well, you don't understand a family. My family. I mean, you know what Revere's like. Anyway, I wouldn't really kill her, you know? I'd scare her. That I would do.
It's somebody else, right? That's what this is about.
I gotta get going.
Look, Chuck, listen, if there's anything I can do, I mean, if you want to talk this thing out.
Yeah, thanks. There is one thing.
Sure, what?
Do you know where I could get a clean gun?
Back. Six. Number 7. And number 8.
What kind of bread are you making these days?
$8.50 an hour.
You're kidding me. Oh, we gotta do something about that. I got something going, but I'm not sure you'd be right for it.
Hey, what's the deal?
You got a problem ripping off some multi-million dollar insurance company?
What kind of bread are we doing?
How does 10,000 sound?
Ghetto blasters?
Pink caddies.
I didn't know you ever came down this way.
Yeah, I'm gonna be down here tomorrow night. I know the hospital will be at birthing classes. It's just 2 minutes from here.
Carol's gonna be with you?
Yeah, sure. She's bringing the ski masks.
You still haven't told me what we're doing down here.
We're fencing some jewelry. We'll be collecting the insurance later. All right, all we're doing is a handoff. And you meet me down here tomorrow night at exactly 8:30. We park right here. All right? So what do you say, you in?
Mr. Stewart, do you want to see anyone again? Mr. Stewart?
Walk him out.
It was really dark, but the third one looks the most like him.
The most like him? You mean some of the others look like him too, Mr. Stewart?
We're not cross-examining Mr. Stewart here, Counsel.
Mr. Stewart, can I speak to you for a second?
Well,
Yeah, I know. The rearview mirror had dust on it.
Boston Michelle, held their Kim. Long-awaited lineup in the Stewart case today. Police sources have repeatedly said the delay was necessary.
We're in print with a story that Chuck Stewart conclusively identified Ben.
My source, who was in the room, said it was the most positive ID he had ever seen.
My guy at Homicide said the same thing.
Well, not everyone agrees.
Robert Sheketoff, the public defender for the man police suspect of shooting Carol Stewart, told News for New England tonight that Charles Stewart was unsure and hesitant when he attended a lineup at police headquarters today. Stewart could only say that William Bennett looked most like his wife's assailant.
Bob Sheketoff isn't lying. Why would they leak just the opposite?
Because Willie's going down.
Can't do it. Can't go on with this no more, man.
You don't have a choice.
Look, man, Willie ain't do no white bitch. All right? You know it.
Who got to you, Duane?
Man, nobody need to get to me.
I know you're afraid of Willie.
Look, I heard some stuff, all right? I mean, maybe the dude doing the talking, he wasn't so reliable.
You heard Willie say it. You heard him say he killed her.
Man, Willie wasn't even in that room.
But he was in the car. You heard the guy say that.
Look, I heard some dude talking. Okay? I mean, he's the one who lied, not me.
I'm going to start investigating Chuck Stewart. I'll keep it quiet.
Forget it. It's not going to happen.
Stewart used to tell people he went to Brown on a football scholarship. I call it Providence. Brown never heard of Chuck Stewart. They don't have a football scholarship. This guy's a figment of his own imagination.
All salesmen tell white lies.
Nurse at the hospital told me about a young blonde that came to visit him.
Pat, I'm telling you, don't stick your nose in
it. Where's the case against Bennett? Our own witnesses are recanting.
The people calling the shots in this case don't want to hear about Charles Stewart.
What does that mean? We're homicide. We investigate murders in this town.
In this case, hit the papers. We nearly had lynch mobs tearing Mission Hill apart. We went in there looking for a black shooter. We showed we were in control. And when the dust settles, we better have been right.
What if we were wrong?
Matt, now don't get mad at me. My family knows this lawyer, John Perenni. He's a nice guy.
Who said you could go to a lawyer?
We're talking about murder here.
You told him that? You said murder?
Matt, you're in trouble.
Because too many people know.
That's my fault. You told Michael, you told me. How many other people did you tell? Think about it. What if somebody tells the cops? What if somebody says you're an accomplice?
I was not an accomplice.
Then get some advice. Talk to this guy.
Jack Dawley's our lawyer.
He's also Chuck's lawyer. Matt, you gotta start looking out for you.
Chuck is my brother.
Does that mean you're willing to go to jail for him?
Good. Yeah, really good.
All the properties up there have gone right through the roof.
So I thought, you know, maybe I would buy that line, you know.
Let them walk
aside. Mr. Stewart, everyone in the shop's been following the case. We just want to let you know how sorry we are about your wife and your son.
Francine?
Thanks.
Yeah. Restocked
it. Did you get the cuticles on the little one, son?
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
I heard about a restaurant for sale out in Foxborough. I might as well shoot down there and take a look at it, huh? How do you get to Foxborough? You just stay on 95?
I got a map in the office.
I still can't bend over very well. Would you mind slipping my socks on for me? Okay. Thank you. Here you go.
Thank you. We're all meeting here. You better come over.
What's going to happen?
We're going to tell Mom and Dad.
What are you going to tell them?
that Chuck was involved. We're not going to say that he killed her.
Wow.
I know, Mike. Get ready.
I don't believe you. You think I'd make this up? Chuck actually said the words, "I'm going to kill Carol."
No. Now, we never talked about shooting anybody. It was supposed to be an insurance scam. That's all it was supposed to be.
All right, calm down. You got a level with me. How do you know this?
I was there.
In Chuck's car?
No. I was in my car. I was parked where Chuck told me to. I didn't see anything.
Okay, take it easy. Chuck asked you to help him with some insurance fraud. You were parked where he told you to be. Then what happened?
Chuck drove up.
Was Carol in the car?
I didn't see her.
So she wasn't in the car?
She may have been slumped over. He tricked me, Jack. What, he figured I could just live with this for the rest of my life?
You're gonna have to go to the DA's office with this. But before you do, you've got to get yourself a lawyer.
Wait, you're my lawyer.
I'm the family lawyer. I can't represent everybody.
Well, what do you think about my story?
I hope you can prove some of this.
You think Carol's engagement ring will do it?
I need to talk to you, Matt. In private.
It's a nice car. Did you get a good deal on the Toyota? What?
Dolly called me. I'm meeting him in his office at 4. He wouldn't say what it was about.
Maybe he has a few questions about Willie Bennett's raspy voice.
Do they know? It was Janet, wasn't it?
No. It was Carol.
That conversation is, of course, privileged.
Well, just tell me if Matt's already gone to the DA.
What I can tell you is that as of this evening, you are going to become the primary focus of the investigation.
What are my options?
Any of these guys will give you first-class defense work.
You're my lawyer.
I can't represent you and the family both. They're conflicts.
Well, don't you think I need you more than Matt does?
You're in trouble. Get yourself a lawyer. Tonight.
Chuck, as soon as you walk out that door, you could be arrested at any time.
Dumping me like everybody else. Well, what good's another lawyer? I mean, they just want me to cut a deal. Because I can't go to prison. Well, I figured a black guy wouldn't last 2 weeks. Well, where can I go? I mean, I need doctors, I need medication, maybe more surgery. I can't cash any more of the insurance now. I can't even go home. You know, even my family's turning on me. Yeah. Yeah, maybe I will.
Chuck, your head's still not in this, is it? Dr. Miller says I have placenta previa. There's a 90% chance I'm gonna have a C-section.
Well, whatever happens, I'll be there with you.
Didn't you want to stay in Huntington?
No, this is the way.
Honey, this couldn't be right.
One of our trucks broke down in Dorchester this afternoon. The tow truck still hadn't gotten there when I had to leave for class.
Couldn't you just call somebody?
No, honey, the store's closed. Shortcut, Carol. Finish your story.
Oh. So, I just told her, Mom, I love the name Christopher. If it's a boy, that's what it's gonna be.
About it. It's a shortcut.
must have taken a wrong turn someplace. Let me check the map.
Could you kind of hurry up? This is a pretty scary neighborhood.
Why, because it's black?
It's not safe. If people can't help, they have to live down here.
No, you're right.
Chucky. Oh, God.
All right, go. Get the hell out of here.
Uh, 510 State Police, Boston.
My wife's been shot. I've been shot.
I love my family. The last 4 months have been real hell. All the allegations have taken all my strength.
Day, the day he jumped, people would come up to me in the newsroom. All right, you must feel good. I told him it was the worst day of my life. It's not enough to have been right. A reporter gets it in the paper.
You're on the air.
I thought whenever a wife gets killed, the cops are supposed to suspect the husband first.
Even when he's got a big hole in his gut? Roxbury, you're on the air.
Cops believed him for one reason, man. Because he was white.
Now look, Stewart fooled me. He fooled a lot of people. You're saying you knew he was lying? What about it, Roxbury? Did you buy Stewart's story?
Yeah, I bought it.